Everybody is focused. They know their job very well. They have a mission and everybody's leaning in the same direction.
And that direction is up at Fleet Readiness Center WESTPAC. Their crews are focused on supporting the fleet, making sure the Pacific Fleet Forces have the tools needed to face any challenge.
Jets can't fly without support equipment, so in and out is our motto. We try to get it in, get it out, get it back to the units so they can use and keep the aircraft supported.
The intent is to get this aircraft through depot level maintenance and back to the operating squadron, back to the warfighter, as soon as we can with the best product that we can.
The mission of FRC WESTPAC is to go out with the fleet where they're deployed, whether it's 5th Fleet, Japan, Rota, Middle East, everywhere OCONUS, and support those aircraft from the maintenance point of view.
Headquartered in Atsuki, Japan, FRC WESTPAC provides depot-level maintenance support from Guam to the Persian Gulf. Its highly trained artisans team up with local contractors to keep the fleet flying.
We work on 23 different types of aircraft over here. If the Marine Corps or the Navy flies it, we work on it. You never know what you're going to get. You have to be adaptable, learn how to do your research and read and make sure of what you're doing.
When it comes to repair and overhaul of Navy and Marine Corps assets, FRC WESTPAC focuses on three mission sets: scheduled depot maintenance, aircraft in service repair afloat and ashore, and ground support equipment repair and overhaul.
We support all four deployed ISR and PMI aircraft lines. So we do a lot of work for four deployed ISR aircraft. Every ship that's deployed, every deployed site, CENTCOM, if there's an issue with the aircraft, it comes to us to resolve it.
In-service repair. The easiest way to describe this would be roadside assistance for AAA. Instead of taking your car to the dealership for getting it repaired, we come out to you and fix your car for you. In this case, it's aircraft.
We're on call anytime, like the Navy, Marine Corps, if they need us there to a different country or a ship, we're there to fix their aircraft.
FRC leaders take pride in helping the warfighter fulfill the mission at hand.
If you drill deep enough, you can trace back the repair that the artisan did on a particular Buno of aircraft and to its ability to fulfill a mission. And that mission may be directly involved in air coverage for Marines on the ground. It may be involved in bombing ISIS. You know, it has real life impact, and our artisans enable that to happen.
It's very rewarding because you can see that, as I said, it's got a direct impact on the fleet. You can see, you know, our guys come, they manufacture a part down the shop, and then from that part they go, they fit on the aircraft, and then 2 days later that aircraft's back and flying again. And that's every day, you can see it.
FRC WESTPAC maintains a high operational tempo. Engineers and mechanics spend a lot of time on the move throughout the region.
Especially while the ship's forward deployed, when the aircrafts have issues, they don't have time to waste to say, hey, you know, we need to get somebody out here. So rather than waiting, we have a team on hand ready to execute any repair to get the aircraft flying and keep it in airworthy condition.
Getting to work the different aircraft is awesome. You have Navy squadrons, we have Marine squadrons, so you don't ever know who you're working for, depending on at the time.
Across the FRC, engineers and other support crew work with their local counterparts to get the job done.
Our foreign nationals are super. Their work ethic is awesome, so it's really, really a pleasure to work with people who want to participate and engage all the time.
The relationship between the Japanese nationals and the military and the USCS is very dynamic, but not as challenging as I had thought it might be, because everybody is focused. They know their job very well.
The multinational effort is one many sailors and Marines enjoy.
It's a culture change. I like the environment. There's a lot going on in the world, and this is one of those places where you can kind of just stand back and look at things and kind of figure out what you want your next step to be. Don't be afraid to come overseas. Japan is nice. Get away from your comfort zone, step out, enjoy your career while you can.